You see these two lads here, to me left, to me right? They have a very specific plan for you. And I'm... Oh, right. They just want me to shut up and kill you.
You're chosen. I have your back.
This army.
hurt you.
We'll win this. Go. Protect the gatehouse.
Finally we meet. You are every bit as I imagined.
You can run, you can hide, but my bolts will still find you. So let's get on with it.
He ain't getting any riper. Take him! Defending forts, you see. Such delicate creatures. So good for delicate things.
Oh!
We'll start the day's entertainment!
Enough! We know little of the Harrigan, mostly folk tales told around the campfire. The stories say they are fierce, pitiless warriors, as cruel as the orcs and as stern as the southern mountains beyond which they hail. Those folk tales convince many a Gondorian child to behave, but I cannot reconcile them with what I see in the only Harrigan I know, Baranor. He is fierce in battle and stern when needs must, but cruel? Never.
Sauron understood that power did not come from armies, but the willingness to sacrifice, to lie in wait. This is the truth he taught me, and so I lie in wait. And when the day comes, I will make my sacrifice. There is a beauty in power. There is a beauty even in violence. But there is no beauty in tyranny. In the rule of one. That is why he must be stopped. I saw a battle upon a tower. I saw the Dark Lord defeated and a Bright Lord take his place. But the world did not change. I repeat, the world did not change.
time we brewed more poison.
Sadras. Here in Mordor, loyalty passes from Orc to Captain to Overlord, and the chain of loyalty ends in a ring of power.
Yeah.
Taken with this beautiful visitor bearing gifts. Banias. Elves are the embodiment of grace. Yet we were taken with this beautiful visitor bearing gifts. Banias. Elves are the embodiment of grace. Yet we were taken with this beautiful visitor bearing gifts.
Look! No,